Since when am I Faust? Chapter 9, Part 2. Nodding, I looked up at the Pegasus.
Yep, and I even have some embarrassing stories to prove it.
I glanced at my daughters as I said those words, and they both had an expression of worry. As I reclined in my bed, my expression softened, and I muttered,
"But that's a story best left for another time."
Both princesses breathed out a sigh of relief, and Cadence put down the notepad that she had taken from Shining with a frown on her face. I glanced over at Twilight with a smirk.
I'm surprised that you didn't tell them earlier.
Reaching forward, I took another sip from my coffee and watched all the attention on Twilight. Applejack took off her hat in amazement, and muttered,
"Well, I'll be."
I smiled, and tried to imitate the warm tone that Lauren would sometimes use at seeing all their shocked faces. Leaning my head forward, I said with a bow,
"It's a pleasure to meet all of you. Please, call me Lauren." "Oh, I'm Pinkie Pie, and that's Rarity, this is Applejack, and that's Fluttershy, and you already know Twilight. And this is Rainbow Dash."
Rarity's magic enveloped her friend as she once again loomed over me. The pink pony was placed down on the ground, and as she floated through the air, Pinkie threw out her arms.
"A million apologies, Your Majesty. What she means is that we are all pleased to meet you as well."
I smiled.
"It's quite alright, Rarity. I'm just glad that despite the events from earlier, you all are okay."
Twilight nodded and lifted a hoof.
"Yes, well, we did find ourselves in a bit of a tight spot at one point, but then Celestia and the guests from the wedding arrived. They helped us escape from the swarm."
The unicorn looked over at Rarity, and she nodded her head.
"Yes, darling. And by the time that we had returned from the vault, the battle was already taking place outside. It was quite a sight to behold from the upper floors, but once we had gotten down to the courtyard, or what was left of it, the battle was already over."
Rarity finished, and she looked over to her friends. It was heartwarming to hear the admiration and care that they had for Lauren, and me, without realizing who I was. I was about to speak, but a knock at the door made me hold my tongue. The door opened, and three mares, along with a small filly, walked in. I stretched myself up to take a look, and as I did, I saw it was Lyra, Minuet, and Lilybreeze. A smile made its way out of my face, and I waved them in. Twilight looked at Lyra and Minuet, and her eyes widened as she recognized her old friends. They waved to each other, and my three attendants approached the foot of my bed. I was glad to see the three of them together, even after witnessing the revelation that Lilybreeze was actually a changeling. I grinned at them, and said,
"So it looks like you three have made up."
Lyra was the first to speak, and she rubbed the back of her head.
"Well, yeah, it was nerve-wracking at first, but now that it's been a few days, I actually think it's kinda cool knowing that she's one,"
she said, and Minuet nodded, seconding her friend's opinion. Then she looked at the others in the room, and realization seemed to dawn on her face. While Lyra shrunk back, a bit concerned for her friend's safety, I looked from the confused faces of the six element bearers to the calm and understanding expressions on the faces of the three princesses and the captain. With a nod, I looked over to Luna.
"I'm assuming that you've brought the rest of the princesses and the captain of the guard up to speed on Lily?"
Luna nodded and stepped forward.
"Yes, I discussed it with them on the night that you were admitted to the hospital."
I smiled.
"Good. And you, Dorlin? How you doing? Last time I saw you, you had some fairly bad injuries."
The maid rubbed her head and looked at the ground awkwardly.
"I'm doing okay now, but during the battle, the doctors were uncertain of my chances. Thankfully, some sort of wave washed through the area, and it felt saturated in love, and it healed my wounds."
I glanced over at Cadence and Shining, and the two let out an audible as they looked away. I looked back to the foot of my bed, as I felt something bumping against it. At the bottom of the bed, where my attendant stood, I saw a tuft of hair jumping up and down.
I wanna see!
A youthful voice called, and Minuet saw the look of curiosity wash over my face. With a grin, she reached down and lifted the small filly. She was a blank flank with violet eyes, a white body, and a light green mane. She looked at me with wide eyes filled with curiosity and wonder.
"Oh, and who might you be?"
I said.
"I'm Penny,"
she shouted with her arms up, and the rest of the mares in the room giggled at the child's antics. Minuet sat the child down on the end of my mattress, and Lily gestured to the filly with a smile.
"Mrs. Faust, princesses, I'd like to introduce you to my little daughter, Penelope Alternate. I was able to bring her from one of the camps made in the mountains outside of Candelot."
I smiled and leaned forward.
"Well, it's certainly nice to meet you, Penny."
The child smiled, and I continued.
"But, will you grant me the honor of seeing your true self?"
The filly's eyes widened, and she looked at her elder sister with a worried expression. Lily looked at her younger sister and assured her,
"It's all right, she's friendly."
The child was hesitant, and she took some time to glance around, looking at the others. But a reassuring hoof from her sister calmed her down. The filly nodded.
"Okay,"
she said, and with a brilliant flash of emeralds, both changelings in the room dropped their disguises. Twilight and her friends stumbled back in shock, and Dash jumped into an attack position. The six mares looked ready to pounce, but before they could do that, I shouted,
"Hold it!"
Getting their attention, they all looked over to me. I raised my eyebrows and waved my hoof.
"It's okay! They're with me.
The group gave me a confused stare and I hesitantly straightened up. Rainbow hit her forehooves together and pointed at Adoralyn.
Alright, fine, but only because the princess mom says so. But I've got my eye on you.
Dash warned. The teenage changeling rolled her eyes and ignored the Pegasus. Compared to what her mother had put her through, Rainbow's words were but an empty threat. She looked over to her sister and smiled. The nymph was trying to catch Lauren's tail as she moved it back and forth. Rainbow looked at the changeling's disregard for her comments and frowned. With a huff, she shrugged it off and joined the other mares. She landed beside Applejack, who was looking around in confusion.
Hold on, ain't they a threat?
She said, pointing at the two, and then she saw everyone else settling down. I sighed and looked over at the group of friends. Giving a warm smile, I said,
No, Adoralyn here was the one who warned us about the incoming invasion, giving us a chance to prepare. That's why the shield is up in the first place.
Luna nodded and looked at the farmer.
Yes, and during the battle, she even risked her life nearly dying in the process of protecting my own.
Both Lyra and Minuet nodded, confirming what the princess had said. But the mares were still on edge. Fluttershy looked like she was about to leap out of her own skin. Shining also seemed to have trust issues, but that was understandable given his situation. Kaden seemed to understand the situation, but still had her guard up behind her smile. Looking at the others in the room and their discomfort, she shook her head, and went to grab a second donut out of the box beside Tia. She opened it and found it empty. Looking up at the white alicorn, Cadence gave her a half-lidded stare and said,
Auntie, that was a box of 24. It's been less than 10 minutes. I'm beginning to think that you have a sweets problem.
Celestia looked down with a blush.
Sorry.
Cadence shook her head and glanced over to the six mares.
I'm heading down to Dunnage's to get some more. Any pony else want to come?
The six of them eagerly nodded and joined her as she headed for the door. With a glance, she gave me a wink and I smiled softly as I understood what she was really doing. Shining followed the group out as well, and as he stepped out of the door, he looked over at me and gave a nod. Then, he stepped out, closing the door behind him.
Those two will make great parents one day. Yeah, I bet they will.
While the group stepped out to a place that they found to be more comfortable, the little changeling snuck over to the top of my bed. She stood tall with her arms above her head, and she declared,
Justice will be swift! Justice will be painful! Justice will be delicious!
Her little form then jumped on me, and she snuggled the top of my head. I instinctively shook and she slid down in front of my head and landed on my chest. I looked down at her, and she looked up at me. She gave me the biggest puppy dog eyes I had ever seen since coming to Equestria. I smiled, and said,
Oh, that's not fair! That's not fair at all! How am I not supposed to love you when you look at me like that?
I wrapped the child in my arms and rubbed her mane. A small changeling giggled at my comments, and then she gained a mischievous grin.
You're gonna love me!
She stumbled forward and planted her face against my chest in a hug. I let her stay like that for a moment before I picked Penelia up and held her above my head. She threw her arms out like she was an airplane. I smiled and looked at the nymph.
Well, despite the circumstances and all the collateral damage, I'm glad I got to meet you, Penny.
As soon as the words left my mouth, the small changeling gave me a grumpy stare.
Hey, I didn't damage anything!
This time all the others in the room began laughing, and the only one left to be confused was Penny. I set her down on my lap and proceeded to stroke her mane. She enjoyed the attention for a few moments, but then a thought seemed to come to her, and then her big eyes went from happy to inquisitive. Taking this as something that I should pay attention to, I paused, and waited for her to say what was obviously on her mind. After a few seconds of looking around, her mouth slowly opened and she asked the one question that I didn't even know I'd been dreading.
Why did you send mommy away?
The room froze, and the nymph stared at me with her big cat-like eyes and proceeded to tilt her head to the side. With a drawn-out sigh, a saddened look came across my face.
Well, first off, I didn't want to send her away, but...
I looked over to my good friend and previous maid for some help. She nodded to my silent plea and trotted over to the side of my bed so she can talk to the nymph face to face.
She sent mom away because she was protecting me.
Penelia turned her head to look at her older sister in confusion.
But why would she need to protect you from mom?
Adoralyn now looked sad, and her head lowered as she continued her explanation.
Because mom didn't agree with changelings and ponies living in peace.
Immediately, the child on my lap got an understanding expression on her face, and her questioning stare vanished.
Oh, so she was gonna make an example out of you. Okay.
Celestia, Luna, and I were in shock. In my lap, the little child spoke about her mother killing to teach as casually as she would talk about the weather. Had she been a little older, I would have pressed on to the matter. But there was always the possibility at this age, she just didn't understand what she said. The nymph, bored of the conversation, turned to hop off my lap. Approaching the side, she eyed the ground with caution. After all, my bed was easily 3 times her height, and with her standing on top of it, that would make it 4. She continued to stare for a few more seconds, before she gave a sad sigh and turned to face me, and the others with a sheepish expression.
Help.
She said. Once again, us older ones gave way to her cuteness and smiled brightly, as some giggled at her pouting face. Leaning forward, I lifted her into my hooves, and proceeded to hand Penny over to her older sister. While I was doing that, one of the wires attached to me came undone, and one of the monitors started going frantic. Adorlin quickly took her sister with her magic and placed her on the ground, and I fought with the wires trying to stop the loud noise before the doctors took notice. The room's doors clicked open, and thankfully, before I moved any further, an emerald light flashed in the corner of my vision. The light reassured me that Adorlin was back to being Lilybreeze, and I felt a sense of tension leave me. The door opened, and a stallion with a white coat and a stethoscope around his neck walked in. His head snapped towards the monitor, and he walked towards it. He quickly got all the wires back into their intended places, and then he turned around to look at the filly in the room. His grumpy glare scared the disguised nymph, and she hid behind her sister's leg. Minuet stepped forward and looked the doctor in the eyes.
Dude, what's your problem?
He leaned forward to speak, but then looked at the two princesses in the room. He held his tongue, and storms back out of the door, muttering to himself about children playing with the equipment and whatnot. The four of them stayed a little longer, but as they checked the time, they realized that they needed to leave soon. Some to return to their duties at the castle, and others to run personal errands. Before they left, I thanked them for passing by along with Tia and Lulu. When Penny realized it was time to go, she looked at her sister with a frown, and chirped,
"Oh, but I didn't get my revenge yet!"
And she leapt from my bed. Lily shook her head, rolling her eyes as she caught the kid in the air before she could reach me.
"Come on,"
she said, as she lifted her little sister onto her back. The nymph grunted and bumped her forehoof against the proto-queen's back. As the group walked over to the door, Penny sat up on her sister's back, and she looked at me, shaking her arm.
"Mark my words, I will get my snuggles,"
she shouted. I laughed. She was just too damn cute for her own good. Waving as they left the room, I called out and said,
"I look forward to it, Penny. Bye-bye."
"Bye."
She waved back, and then leaned her body on the back of Lily's neck. Then, they disappeared from view. Now that was heartwarming. Now how about we get onto our heartwarming donators? Top donators are 630, Peter Coldhard, J10Man, Darkside, and only one thing. TacoCat598, Raiden, Narwhals, Black Moonheart, Pastel Skies, Austin Rollins, CrazyKiller557, Stu Hux, Will, Omicron Lyrae, Chris, Twinkie, Dospo, Delta Omega, Jack Hedge, RuneSyphon9852, Madman Stan, Lizzie Prickett, Drake Lovedragon, Hunter Norman, Stephen Bingham, LineGuy12, Sorcerer Constantine, Hadzaza, Convair, and many more spectacular people. Thank you all so much for watching this video, and live life to the fullest.